And when I make my records and produce my records, I have a vision. And I'm like, you know what? I'm not gonna stop until that vision gets accomplished. I was doing a show or something. I had to come to LA to work. I've been working on my album. And as soon as I got to LA, I said, you know what? Let me call Justin Bieber. I FaceTimed him. He picked up. I was like, yo, JB, what's good? I wanted to present something to you. I don't wanna email it. I don't wanna text it. Well, before I explain, he said, yo, Khaled, come over. Come to my crib, come check me. Man, I hung up the phone so fast. I jumped in the car, I went to his house. As soon as I get to the crib, the man start playing the piano. Like a movie. I got a speaker in my hand, a big speaker I brought, just in case, you know, I'm ready. I got a speaker in my trunk everywhere I go. You know what I'm saying? I'm ready to present. After he's done playing the piano, he's like, where the record at? So I was like, I got it right here. So he sees me with the speaker. He's like, man, don't worry about the speaker. Come jump in my truck. I got a big system in there. So I go in his truck. It ain't no regular truck inside. So the man got fur and all type of lights, it's special. We plug it up. And you know, I'm giving him my little presentation. Before I play it, I'm like, yo, so this record, man, is, you know, I feel like this is gonna be the one. So I play in the record and we vibing. So, you know, I look real quick to look at him and I see him moving his head. So I move back over here and close my eyes to give him that passion look. You know what I'm saying? Just in case he look at me so he know, you know, I wanna make sure it's going right. When the music stopped, he was like, I like this. Yeah, I'm kinda like, don't say too much. Don't start just go with the flow. I was like, no doubt. You want me to text you the instrumental? He's like, yeah, text me the instrumental. So boom, I left it like that. I also told him I wanted to put Quavo and I wanted to put Chance the Rapper and Lil Wayne on there. So I hit Quavo, I'm like, yo, I got this record, I'm telling you it's gonna be big. I need you on it. He's like, yo, Cal, whatever you need, I got you. So we go in the studio and we actually recorded in the studio where Michael Jackson recorded Thriller. You know what I'm saying? And before Quavo and them came in, I went in there to see, because I wanted to experience, I wanted to touch the walls, I wanted to see the vocal booth where this man recorded at. So Quavo and the whole Migos came through, played it for Quavo, and he was like, man, this is crazy. I can see this. And the man really took 5 minutes. 5 minutes listening to the beat, and then he went in the booth and just knocked the verse out. And if you notice, Quavo's melody is like a vibe. It's just like a melody, it just puts you in a trance. I'm Chance the Rapper. I went to go see him. He was at a studio overlooking the ocean in Malibu. And he was having a dinner with his family. I texted him, he's like, yo, come by. I said, I want you on my album, man. He goes, yo, I'll be honored to get on there, man. Playing the record, then he started immediately like catching a vibe, like the head, you know what I mean? He was just vibing. He immediately jumped in the booth and put a bunch of ideas down. Then Lil Wayne, that's my brother. If you check my catalog and my track record with Lil Wayne, we've always made hits together. So anytime I call Lil Wayne, my brother got me. It's just a family thing, you know what I mean? Me and my man Nick Knack, he changed his name now. He changed his name, he got a new name. We in the studio and I told him, I don't wanna put too much drums on here. I wanna put simple drums at the end of each verse. Also, I wanna big up Pooh Bear and shout out to Scooter Braun, you know what I'm saying, for being a part of this big anthem, you know what I'm saying? You can tell by the sound and when you watch the video and the results of it being number one that it was love involved and everybody was just a part of it and excited for it. And everybody played their part just to bring awareness to the greatness. And that's what it's about. It's just a statement. You know, I'm the one. You know, and that's how I feel. I'm the one, the only one, another one. You know what I'm saying? If you don't wake up in the morning and look at the mirror and say you're the greatest and you the one, then what are you? I know you can't wake up in the morning, look in the mirror and say, I'm number two. You can't say, I'm all right. Nah, we the best. You know what I'm saying? That's what it is. You know what I mean?
Another one. Don't you know, God? Don't you know, God? Like-